Recorded Books presents Real As It Gets by ReShonda Tate Billingsley, narrated by Jasmin Walker. Chapter 1. The image on the screen gave me chills. I knew Savannah Vanderpool. She was a beautiful former Miss Teen Miami who had branched out to movies. We'd taken some modeling classes together when I was in middle school, and although I didn't talk to her much anymore, we kept in touch through Instagram and Twitter. It wasn't often that I gave other girls props, but Savannah had earned hers. She was Beyonce, Ciara, and Megan Good rolled up into one. A class act, that's who Savannah was. Was. Because this chick I was looking at right then was anything but classy. She looked like a crackhead, meth head, and dope fiend rolled up into one. Savannah's eyes were sunken, almost like her face was swallowing them. She had dark circles under her eyes, and her face was taut and dry. Her skin was sagging, looking like it was just hanging onto her bones. Her once beautiful blonde hair was stringy, and the dark roots were showing. The only modeling she could do now would be in a Just Say No drug ad. Maya, my director Manny whispered in my earpiece, go, you're live. I caught myself. I didn't usually let anything get me off my game when I was in hosting mode at my talk show, Rumor Central, but seeing Savannah's picture had definitely left me speechless. Wow, I guess you can say I'm a little stunned myself, I continued, turning my attention back to the camera. If you knew Savannah Vanderpool like I knew Savannah Vanderpool, you'd be just as shocked. We'd gotten the story about Savannah being arrested just minutes before I was going on air. My producer, Dexter, had handed me a sheet with some limited information and told me to wing it. I had no problem with that because dishing dirt was what had made me so popular on Rumor Central. I was even used to dishing dirt about my friends, especially because I was usually the one who had dug up the dirt. Even though I'd stopped airing my friends' dirty laundry, I had no problem digging in other celebrities' backyards. I had to. Since I started Rumor Central 4 months before, it had become one of the hottest gossip shows in the country. We were now shown in 17 major cities, and my popularity was through the roof. Celebs as big as Usher and Rihanna called me when they wanted to slip out a little gossip. And other celebrities tried to become my best friends to keep their dirt off the air. So, a little scandalous story never shocked me. But this picture of Savannah? I wasn't ready for that. This is just into the Rumor Central studios, I continued. So we haven't been able to get all the details, but rumor has it that this mugshot is from Savannah's arrest last night after she caused a scene at the Sports Illustrated reception. Apparently, she arrived to the event high, dazed, and acting out. Witnesses say she was actually in a psychotic-like state. Organizers saw her and refused to let her go on stage. We're told Savannah was so high that she took off all her clothes and began running through the party screaming and crying as she destroyed everything in sight. I took a deep breath as an earlier photo of Savannah as Miss Teen Miami flashed on the screen. I continued. Our sources tell us Savannah was high on K2, a hyped-up version of Kush, the popular synthetic drug sweeping the country. We don't know much about K2, but you'd better believe that Rumor Central is all over this story, and we'll keep you updated. I'm your girl, Maya Morgan, and we'll be back right after this. I tossed to the break and motioned for my new assistant, Yolanda, to get me some water. Usually we kept it light and gossipy on Rumor Central. I didn't get all deep into stories, and this was exactly the reason why. These kind of stories were just too much. You okay? Yolanda asked as she handed me a cooled bottle of Fiji water. I took a sip of the water. Yeah, just tripping over that picture. I glanced over at the photo, which was still up on the monitor. I'd seen Savannah about 6 months before, and she had looked fine. How could someone get like that in just a few months? Dexter came over to me on the set as Yolanda scurried away. Great job, Maya. I got some more details. Apparently, this K2 is more powerful than Kush, and it's getting really hot among celebrities. It looks like spices or potpourri, and they say it was created in China or Korea as a plant growth stimulant. It's about 10 times more potent than meth. Just wow, I said, shaking my head again at the picture. I knew some celebs that dabbled in drugs, but judging from the way she looked, Savannah had done a lot more than dabble. I just can't believe that she's fallen off like that. Do you know Savannah? Dexter anxiously asked as he ran his hands through his head full of bright red hair, something he did whenever he was excited. I mean, personally? I figured you did since you know everybody. Dexter was right about that. Before I was on air, first as one of the five members of the Miami Divas reality show, then as the host of my own show, I was already at the top of the food chain as the leader of Miami's It Click, as one magazine had put it. In fact, that was why I'd been approached to do the reality show in the first place. Miami Divas hadn't done as well as they wanted, so they'd canceled it, fired the other four divas, and given me my own show. That had been the smartest thing since the invention of the internet, because in no time, I became the go-to chick for all the latest celebrity gossip, dirt, and entertainment news. Rumor Central had exceeded everyone's expectations and had even been picked up by networks in several other cities. My BFF Sheridan had been one of the original Miami Divas who was fired, and that had led to a whole lot of drama, but we squashed that and we're back to kicking it. I couldn't say the same about the other busters from Miami Divas. Shay, Bali, and Evian still had stank attitudes about the way everything had gone down. They claimed we had a pact to stick together, and I sold them out by taking my own show. As if any of them would have turned it down if the shoe was on the other foot. Whatever. Bali didn't even live in Miami anymore, and he still let me know he was mad with messy text messages, all of which I just ignored. "So do you know her or not?" Dexter asked again, snapping me out of my thoughts. I knew he wasn't asking out of concern. He was probably trying to see if I could get some kind of inside scoop. "Yeah, I know her. Or at least I used to know her," I replied. "The Savannah I knew would never allow herself to look like that," I pointed at the screen.
"The research department is trying to see if we can find any other celeb arrest behind this drug," Dexter said.
I didn't get it because drugs were whack. Anything that took me off my A game, I didn't need to be doing. And as fabulous as I was, I didn't need anything messing up my flawless bronze skin, long, all-natural, soft brown hair, and perfect Pilates-toned body. I was a quarter piece because a dime just didn't do me justice. So no way would I ever let some kind of drug, be it weed, X, coke, or anything else, take that away from me. Savannah used to be the same way. Was K2 powerful enough to make her change her mind? I glanced at the picture again. Obviously it was, because Savannah had basically thrown her life away for it. And that, I would never understand. Chapter 2. I hadn't been able to get that picture of Savannah out of my head all night long. When I'd left the station after the show, I tried to call my friend Kirby. She and I used to take modeling classes with Savannah, and I knew the two of them talked regularly. I was hoping Kirby could tell me what was going on, but I hadn't been able to get in touch with her. I glanced at my watch. Late again. Since I hadn't slept well, I was running late for school. Oh, who was I kidding? I was always running late. But this time, I was later than normal. It was almost third period. "Who's the fiercest chick in Miami High?" a voice from behind me said just as I entered the building. I turned around and smiled at my BFF, Sheridan Matthews, looking her usual fly self in an orange Juicy Couture jacket and rock star jeans. "Why, me, of course," we both said together, although I didn't have my usual oomph. "What's up with you?" Sheridan asked, losing her smile. "You seem out of it." "Just tired," I said.
"Me too,"
Sheridan replied, yawning as she got in step with me. Sheridan was the daughter of the legendary Glenda Matthews, who was probably the hottest singer-actor in Hollywood. Miss Matthews wanted to keep Sheridan away from the glitz of Hollywood, so she kept my BFF in Miami with some of their family, who were supposed to keep an eye on her. Notice I said supposed to, because those shiesty relatives just took Miss Matthews' money and let Sheridan run free. That was perfectly fine with Sheridan, though. She loved not having to answer to anyone. Fortunately, she had a good head on her shoulders and stayed out of trouble. Well, major trouble anyway. Sheridan and I walked past a group of students who were dragging up the hallway, late as well. Because of all the money our parents paid for us to go to the prestigious private Miami High School, the teachers often cut us slack when it came to things like punctuality. But I've been pushing my luck since I'd started hosting Rumor Central. Not only was I late almost daily, my grades were plummeting because I barely had time for anything outside of the show. I've been trying to get my academic act together since my mom had threatened to make me quit my show if I didn't get my grades up. As if that would really happen. Even still, I wasn't trying to flunk out of my senior year, so I've been working on getting my grades up. There was nothing cute about being dumb. I'd given up the whole tutor thing because I hadn't had much luck with that. The last two tutors I had had turned out to be psychopaths. Long story. Now, I was just trying to do it myself. I know I look fabulous and my body is here, but my mind is still snuggled up under my pillow, Sheridan said as we walked into the building just as the bell rang, dismissing the second period. Who are you telling? I said. It took everything under the sun for me to come to school today, but I have Mrs. Washington's test next. She said if I miss it, I'll get a zero since it's a major grade, so here I am. Sheridan stopped and stared at me. Are you worried about your grade in your class? Is that why you look all stressed? I shook my head. My grades were concerning to me, but not enough to lose any sleep over. Nah, did you see the show yesterday? That's what's on my mind. Oh, yeah, Sheridan said, scooting out of the way as two of my silly classmates nearly knocked us over as they played in the hall. Idiots! Sheridan snapped, then turned back to me. I tried to call you last night after I saw that. Is that the Savannah that you used to model with? I nodded. Yeah, that's her. Wasn't that story wild? Yeah, she looked horrible, Sheridan replied. What happened to her? What do you think happened? She got strung out, then she flipped out at a party. I haven't been able to get much more info than that. I was hoping that I could talk to Kirby sometime today because I really wanted to know what had happened to Savannah. I just can't believe it. I mean, didn't she just score that Sports Illustrated cover? Sheridan asked. Mm-hmm, I replied. But I'm sure they don't want her posing now. Savannah was just 2 years older than me, but she had already scored some gigs even seasoned models couldn't get. Can you? I stopped talking as my ex, Bryce Logan, walked toward me in the hallway. His arm was planted firmly around this girl named Callie, and she was giggling and smiling at him all dreamily. Yes, Bryce had money, looks, and physique. He was all that and then some, but he was also history, which meant that he wouldn't be getting the time of day from me. I was all prepared to ignore him, but he tried to ignore me first. Whatever. I just laughed as I opened my locker and pulled out my binder. The last thing I was going to do was give him any satisfaction that he was even on my radar. So that's how he's going to play it? Sheridan asked, turning her nose up at Bryce. He and Callie had stopped at the end of the hallway and were kissing all over each other. How tacky. He can play it however he wants, I replied, not looking over his way, even though I could see out of the corner of my eye the way Callie was eyeballing me. Bryce can have that D-list chick. Bryce had been my boo. I thought he was my soulmate, but we broke up because he let people fill his head with a bunch of lies about me. Twice. He tried to apologize, but I didn't get down like that. If a guy was going to be with me, he was going to be ride or die, and nobody would be able to tell him something about me to make him just dump me. Although I would never admit to anyone that Bryce had actually dumped me and not the other way around. Yeah, he needs to know you've moved on anyway, Sheridan said, raising her voice so that Bryce could hear. He didn't look up, but I could tell by the way his body tensed up that he'd heard her. Moved on? Not quite. J-Love, the R&B singer who had just dropped yet another chart-topping hit, was still going after me hard, and I had been tempted to give him some play, but he dissed me too. And although I may eventually give him a second chance, he was going to have to work hard for it, something he'd definitely been doing. I glanced down at my diamond tennis bracelet, which Sheridan quickly noticed. Is that another gift from J-Love? She asked. Yep. I held up my wrist, revealing my ruby watch. And this is a gift from Alvin. Sheridan was definitely impressed, but still she shook her head. Nice. But I don't know why you're wasting your time with that nerd. Alvin is cool, I said. Alvin had helped me do some computer stuff when I had been trying to track down this crazed fan who was stalking me a few weeks before. And although he'd ended up being a great guy, he was still too geeky for my taste. And Maya Morgan doesn't do nerds. Yes, I'd taken him to our winter dance, but that was about the extent of it. We talked on the phone almost every day and joked all the time. I really liked having him as a friend, but I didn't see it going any further than that. Must be hard being you. Sheridan laughed. I didn't. It is. Well, you can have your pick of guys. Alvin, J-Love, and I'm sure you could get Bryce back if you wanted. I don't, I said without hesitation. That hoochie can have him. Well, I'm just saying, if you did want him, you could get him. J-Love wants you. Alvin wants you. Must be nice. I knew Sheridan was stressing because her boyfriend, Reginald, had moved away. And although lots of guys tried to holler at her, since she was almost as cute as me, none of them were on her level. So she was single and hating it. "Nah, right now I'm just doing me," I said. The show was keeping me busy. Digging up dirt and gossip on celebrities wasn't easy, and since I no longer ratted out my friends, I had to work even harder to get the scoop. We stopped in front of my third period classroom. "Well, let me get in this class and get ready for this stupid test. I'll talk to you later." Sheridan waved, then bounced onto her class down the hall. I walked in and slid in a desk near the back, where I usually sat. I looked at the empty seat in front of me, then leaned over to the girl who sat on the side of me. "Hey, where's Lynn?" I made it a point to sit behind Lynn Vo because he was the smartest boy in the class, and I might need to borrow some answers from him for today's test. The girl, I didn't even know her name because she was a scholarship student and didn't run in my circle, replied, "Girl, you haven't heard?" "Heard what?" I wanted to add, "Dumbo," because if I'd heard where he was, I wouldn't have asked her. "Lynn got on some of that stuff."
"What stuff?"
"He got some bad kush, apparently some kind of intensified kush, and they had to rush him to the hospital. His brain is all jacked up," she said.
"What?" I asked in disbelief.
"Yeah, he..."
She stopped talking when the teacher walked in and shot us be quiet warning looks. I was speechless anyway. Our celebrity circles were one thing. I knew sometimes things could get out of hand there, but if this drug was making its way to my classmates, it was a lot bigger than anyone might have ever thought.
Chapter 3. I was a little surprised to see my dad's car in the driveway when I made it home after school. He usually didn't get in until really late during the week. I knew my mom had her sorority executive board meeting and wouldn't be bothering me, so I'd actually been looking forward to a quiet evening at home. I still hadn't caught up with Kirby and wanted to try and do some digging myself to find out more about what had happened with Savannah. But just as I was about to complain, images of this new Christian Dior dress I wanted popped in my head. Even though I had my own money, I'd much rather spend my dad's. So I'd been meaning to ask him to buy me the dress for this party I had coming up. Now would be the perfect time. "Dad," I called out as I set my keys on the kitchen counter and dropped my messenger bag on the floor.
"Miss Maya,"
Sui said in a chastising tone. She gave me a stern look, then motioned toward the floor. I gave her a look right back.
"I ask you not to leave your bag in the floor," she said.
"Isn't that what we pay you for?" I glanced around the room. "Where's my dad?" I could tell she wanted to say something, but she just gritted her teeth and said,
"He's in the living room,"
as she bent down and picked my bag up off the floor. I walked through our spacious kitchen and into the front room. "Dad!" I stopped in my tracks when I saw my dad and the person standing in front of him.
"Oh my God, Travis!"
I raced over and threw my arms around my favorite cousin. "What are you doing here, boy?"
"Can you at least say hello?"
he asked after hugging me. Travis stepped back from me and gave me the once-over.
"Let me get a good look at you, girl. You ain't a little nerdy chick anymore," he said, turning me around.
I put my hand on my hip and cocked my head. "I was never a little nerdy chick, sweetie."
"My bad,"
he laughed.
"You right. You always were a diva."
"Hello, honey,"
my dad said, coming over and kissing me on the forehead. "Hey, Dad." I turned right back to Travis. "What's going on? What are you doing here?" Travis lived in Brooklyn, New York. I hadn't seen him since my grandfather's funeral last year. But up until then, we used to be thick as thieves, as my grandfather used to like to say. We were close in age. He was only a few months older than me. And he was the brother I'd never had. Travis and I still talked via text, but I had always said that there was nothing like actually hanging out with him. Travis didn't answer my question. Instead, he just looked over at my dad. "Where's Aunt Bev?" I asked. Aunt Bev was my dad's older sister and his only sibling. They weren't that close. But I just assumed it was because my dad was a workaholic and really didn't have time for anything but work.
"Well," my dad began, "we wanted to surprise you."
My dad patted Travis on the back.
"Travis here is going to come stay with us for a while."
"What?"
I exclaimed. "What do you mean coming to stay with us?" I didn't know how I felt about that. Don't get me wrong, I love Travis. He was definitely cool, but I hadn't shared my home or my parents with anyone, like, ever.
"Just what he said," Travis replied. "I'm staying with you guys."
"Staying with us for what?"
"Oh, so you don't want me here?"
he asked, a huge grin across his face. Travis had been a charmer for as long as I could remember, and it was that dimpled smile that usually did it. I'm just trying to figure out what's going on, I replied.
Oh, that's right. You're like a reporter. You go digging for answers.
That's right, I replied. And I'm not a reporter. I'm the star, baby. Travis laughed as he plopped down on the sofa.
Yeah, I caught that show once or twice. I told everyone in Brooklyn you were my peeps. Nobody believed me, though. I tried to call you, but your secretary wouldn't let me through.
Whatever. You didn't try to call me, I said. He smiled. In fact, I haven't heard from your janky behind except for your text.
Yeah, I've been a little busy.
My father cut his eyes at him.
Mm-hmm, busy staying in trouble. But all that's about to change, right, son?
Yeah, unk.
I'm gonna be a regular Boy Scout.
Travis held up his hand like he was taking some kind of oath. What kind of trouble you been getting into?
See, what had happened was, he laughed. Seriously, it wasn't even me. It was my boys. And Moms was tripping, talking about she can't handle me since my dad left. Yeah, but Uncle Miles can handle you, so don't get out of line,
my dad said, pointing a warning finger at Travis. Travis saluted him.
Yes, sir. I'm going to get back to work. You get settled in. Suey will show you to your room and get you situated. I have a friend who's giving me a great deal on a 2010 Camaro for you, so you'll have your own transportation.
At the mention of a car, Travis beamed. I couldn't help but frown. So now we were buying him a car? But I decided not to trip. It wasn't like it was some luxurious car anyway.
Who is Suey? Travis asked.
The maid, I replied. Remember?
Dang, I forgot y'all were rolling like that. So what time is the chef preparing dinner?
He stood and walked back over to me.
That's what I'm talking about, I said, laughing. I've been trying to tell Dad that we need a personal chef.
Suey cooks just fine, my dad called out as he headed into his study.
Travis stared at me a minute. I was used to that since I was all that, but it was creeping me out coming from a family member. Would you stop looking at me like that?
I'm just tripping off of you. You look like a little woman now.
Whatever, boy. He walked around the living room. My mom had actually remodeled since the last time he had been here. It had already been nice then, but she had gotten bored of the place we'd lived in since I was two. She'd knocked out a wall in the living room. Now, when you entered the foyer, it opened into a big rotunda and the living room sat to the left in a large, spacious area. Travis used to always say our living room looked like one of those homes in the magazines his mom drooled over. Whenever Aunt Bev used to visit, I remember she would get all teary-eyed like she was sad. My mom had told me it was because she was envious of her brother. Envious, but not jealous, my mother stressed,
because envious just meant that she wished she had what her brother had with no evil intent.
Personally, both sounded like hating to me, but whatever.
So what's going on, little cuz? You all big time now,
Travis beamed proudly.
I mean, you're kicking butt and taking names. I see your picture everywhere.
I'm just trying to do me. I tossed my hair over my shoulders, since no one else can.
And I heard you were dating the singer J-Love.
You heard wrong, I said, rolling my eyes and losing my smile.
Okay, whatever you say.
Travis grabbed his bag.
Show me to my portion of the castle.
I led the way upstairs and showed him to the guest room. He started unpacking. I looked at all his clothes spread out on the bed. Ooh, this is nice, I said, picking up a gold heavy-duty watch. He took the watch out of my hand.
Only thing I have worth something, and the only thing my dad ever gave me.
I didn't remember much about Travis's dad, except that he wasn't around. Oh, when did he give it to you? Travis tossed it back in a duffel bag.
Right before he left? I guess you can call it a parting gift. It's supposed to be worth a lot of money. I just been hanging on to it.
He paused.
Well, because it's all I got left.
I remember that talking about his dad always made him uncomfortable, so I changed the subject. So for real, what you been getting into? I asked as he put his suitcase up on the bed.
Just trouble.
He replied as he unzipped his suitcase and started removing baseball caps and all kinds of hip gear.
But I left the trouble back in Brooklyn. I'm starting over. So what time do we leave for school in the morning?
We? I asked, sitting straight up. What do you mean, we? He flashed a big grin.
Yup, I'm the newest student at Miami High. You didn't think I was going to come here and not finish school, did you?
What? We're in the middle of the school year. And you must have forgotten my uncle is Miles Morgan. He pulled some strings and got them to find a spot for me. Travis walked over and started putting his stuff in the dresser drawers. He was setting up shop like he really was going to be here a while. I wanted to ask him who was paying for his school since Aunt Bev didn't have the money, but of course, I knew the answer to that. My dad was footing that bill, which meant less money for me. I didn't know why Travis couldn't go to the public school down the street. All I knew was if my dad was shelling out money for Travis's tuition, I didn't want to hear anything when I asked for money. As if he was reading my mind, Travis said, "Don't worry, little cousin. I'm not going to be in the way. I'm just going to keep letting you do you." I finally smiled. The more I thought about it, it might be nice to have my cousin around. I have my share of friends, but it would be nice to have some family around. "Cool. As long as you don't forget, it's only one star in the Morgan household," I said with my hands on my hips. Travis grinned. "Believe me, I'm low-key. And I got a feeling even if I did forget, you wouldn't hesitate to remind me." "You got that right," I said, as I stood and made my way out and back down to my father's study to convince him to give me the money for my Christian Dior dress. So I readied my, "I don't want to lose your love, Daddy, now that you have a boy," act. If that didn't get my $4,000 dress, nothing would. Chapter 4. I was not ready for today. I love my cousin. I really did. And I definitely loved kicking it with him. He was cool people, but too cool. Whenever Travis was around, he stole my shine. And I could tell today would be no exception. "What's up?" he said, smiling at the two girls, cheesing like he was some kind of superstar.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.